In this video, we will be looking at what comes with your Smart Ball Valve and how to set it up with the Smart Life app.
Inside the box, you will find your Smart Ball Valve labeled for Wi-Fi or Zigbee, depending on the model you've purchased, a power cable, and a user manual.
Your manual has important safety information as well as a step-by-step instruction on how to install and operate the Smart Ball Valve through the Smart Life app. To set up your Smart Ball Valve, you'll first need to get your smartphone or tablet, then download the Smart Life app. You can find a QR code for the app in your user manual. Once this app is installed, go ahead and launch it. You can also create a free user account, or you can also set the app up as a guest if you don't want to use an account. Now you can plug your Smart Ball Valve in and you should see a blue LED light blinking. This means it's in pairing mode and it is ready to be linked to the app. If you're using a Wi-Fi model, make sure your phone or tablet is connected to the Wi-Fi network you want your valve to use, and open the Smart Life app. You should see a plus icon in the corner and scroll down until you see others on the left. Now you can pick Connect Wi-Fi from the list. It will ask you for the username and password of your Wi-Fi. Then it will confirm that your Smart Ball Valve is blinking. If all of this looks good, go ahead and hit Next. Wait for it to find and link up with the ball valve, then hit Done. If for some reason the light on your valve is not blinking, just press and hold the manual switch button for about 5 seconds and it should start blinking. If you get the Zigbee version of this valve, then you'll want to follow the steps on the Smart Life app to link your Zigbee hub, not included, with the Smart Life app.
After the hub is set up, make sure the LED light on the valve is blinking and add it as a sub-device to your hub. You can tap Add Sub-Device, confirm that the LED light is blinking, and it will find your valve and pair it. You should now see a screen with several options for your valve, like setting up a schedule to open and close the valve. You can tap Schedule here at the bottom. Here you can set timing options, so let's go through those. You can set the time of day you want to schedule your valve to open. Which months you want the schedule to run, keep in mind you can select multiple months here. Once you select which months you want your schedule to run, you can now select which days of those months you want your valve to run. Keep in mind you have 31 days on this list, but not every month has 31 days in them. Next, you can set the duration the valve stays open each time the schedule is run. Keep in mind that it does take some time for the valve to open enough for water to run through. You can also add a note to yourself. The last option you have is the threshold. This is how much the valve opens during the timer. As mentioned before, keep in mind it will take several seconds to get to the set threshold, so you have to account for this during the duration settings.
Now your Smart Ball Valve is linked and ready to go.